What up, bitches? I don't have my sound playing through my headset today, so it's going to be a little weird. But I think that's why I sound fucking retarded half the time when we talk, because I'm hearing myself talk through my headset half a second afterwards. Anyways, today we got another banger coming at you, and I got a fat-ass sweater, and I got a fat-ass cock, too. Mm. We have number three of our top breakdowns, and it's another banger, man. It's another banger, David. What is it?
Eternal Refuge by Whitechapel.
External Refuge right by here. Whitechapel. Last week, we had number four. It was Oceano, Samuel the Destroyer. No, I'm just kidding. Which Oceano song was it? They got so many of them, I don't even know.
It was District of Misery.
District of Mystery. That's what it was.
Yeah.
So,
That's a good song, too, though.
Yeah, it's a good song. That's why it was number four, of course. It's a good song. If not, it wouldn't be on the list.
No, I was saying Samuel the Destroyer.
Oh, I gotcha. Yeah, it's a good song, too. Or last week, Samuel the Destroyer. I'm fucking this all up. Number five.
Are you doing this on purpose or accident?
Kind of doing it on purpose, kind of doing it on accident. I'm trying to fuck it up a little bit because I fucked the whole video up last week, but I'm kind of fucking it up even worse. So BTM FDR was number five. That's David's favorite song. That's why it was so ranked good. So high, just because he likes it so much. And then number three this week, we have what David just said. Anyways, the way we got to the rankings was take our top 15 songs of these artists we like, not really top favorite songs, but best breakdowns. We rate them 1 through 15, combine the two scores, put them together. Tiebreaker is whoever has the highest ranking out of the two of them. So if David has one as a 1, I have one as a 15. If it's got a 1, it got a number 1. It's higher than a song that got a number 3 is the highest. So boom, that's that. Also, we have merch. Yeah. We have these mugs right here. Obviously, the black one's pretty cool. Obviously, the white one is very cool because it says as a mug on it. Yeah, I'm going to zoom in on that for you. And obviously, if you get the black one, it's definitely worth your money because, number one, it's got this white stripe there for no fucking reason, and it doesn't have it on the other side. And two, it doesn't say as a mug because I'm a fucking idiot, and I didn't change the text color. So I might fix it, I might not, just because it's fucking stupid. I guess I should, so that way you can get the full $6 worth for your mug.
It's kind of funny, though.
It is kind of fucking funny. I mean, it's funny that David ordered it, and yeah, he's the one that got the fucked up version. So. I didn't know it was in black. I had no idea. I thought it was only in white, so I fucked that up. Anyways, we got External Refuge today. Internal Refuge today. And I've got diarrhea. So let's go ahead and get this started.
Your kind. killer fucking song.
I fucked that up. I didn't have any sound playing through my headset for the first, like, 10 seconds of
the
song.
Dude, me neither.
No way.
Yeah.
I saw you moving, and I was trying to play it off like I had sound. And now I can hear myself in my headset, so I fucked that whole video up. But...
yeah, I started it, and I was like, wow, this is taking longer to start than I remember. And then I was like, oh, the fucking video's muted.
No, fuck. My computer was muted. Fuck, dude. So, that song is fucking sick. Yeah. Number one, because of the lyrics... they're just fucking incredible. The ending of the song, it's just killer, man. The fucking fuck your, I don't know what he says. It sounds like he says fuck your face, so I just play along with that. But is that what he says? I have no clue.
It's either face or face.
Oh, so you have no idea either.
And then he says fuck your kind, fuck your
oh, I
words,
thought he said fuck,
fuck
your,
your
cock.
World.
Huh? I always thought he said fuck your cock.
Cock?
Yeah.
Why?
I don't know. It just sounds heavy. I always thought that's what he said.
What part does it sound like he says fuck your cock?
He says fuck your face, fuck your cock. And fuck your world. Like, I thought it's pretty heavy. Like, fuck your cock. Like, what? What'd you say to me? Like, if someone said that to me, I'd fight them right away. I'd throw hands. I'd
hey,
hands
fuck instantly. Your cock. Isn't that just someone saying they want to fuck you?
I don't know. You tell me. I mean, when you say fuck you and give someone the middle finger, are they saying they want to fuck you?
Yeah, no.
I know.
Yeah, I guess not.
It's like saying fuck your pussy. Like, that's pretty bad. Like, if you say that to some stranger in public, I'm pretty sure they're gonna get pretty pissed.
If someone said that to me, like, in the middle of a bar or something, I'd laugh my ass off.
Fuck your pussy.
Fuck your pussy.
Could you imagine some guy's mad and as you're walking away,
hey,
he says, hey,
you know what?
Fuck
you.
Pussy.
And fuck your pussy.
Yeah.
That'd be hilarious.
That's some fighting words right there. That's some brutal fighting words. Nah, but I like the fuck your world, that whole ending of it. It's pretty fucking sick. But leading up to it, this fucking thrash metal beat, I like that too.
Yeah. Yeah, I would say the breakdown in that song is definitely the end. But they have some other little ones throughout the song as
clearly
well.
Clearly you're a big White Chapel fan. You got White Chapel there, White Chapel up there.
Yeah.
David's big into White Chapel. How many times have you seen him live, David?
Oh, fuck. At least 6 times.
Are they one of the best bands to see live?
I mean, they're my favorite, like, deathcore band.
To listen to. But live-wise?
But to see live, I mean, they're up there. It's really hard for me to decide who's the best.
Are they better than Slaughter to Prevail?
Show-wise? I would say yes, because both times I've seen Slaughter to Prevail, the beginning of their show, they always have an issue with, like, one of their guitars not being plugged in, or the fucking
that's
because
they're
not
low budget
in.
Okay, besides the fact that they have technical difficulties every show, because they're one of the warm-up bands, they're never the headline act.
Yeah,
who's better?
I guess
Slaughter to Prevail was the headline band and White Chapel was the opener.
So Slaughter to Prevail I think is better about getting the crowd more involved.
I think so too. What about Chelsea
and the vocalists are just way more into it than Phil is from White Chapel. Beautiful.
So
Jack's David, drinking a glass of milk, by the way,
it's
and I'm
fucking
drinking
coconut
beer.
Milk, thank you. So David, it's got 280 calories, thank you.
Nice.
Maybe we should give him a hint for next week what the video is gonna be. I'll just drop a little teaser here. Who's a better band to see live, Chelsea Grin or White Chapel? Oh man, this is, how do you even question this, dude? I'm not even gonna let you answer that just because you're thinking about it.
I mean, it's hard to tell because, like, you're talking about White Chapel now.
A fanboy.
Yeah, I mean, you're talking about Chelsea Grin now or the original Chelsea Grin?
Chelsea Grin in general is great. Like,
huh?
Chelsea Grin in general is great. Doesn't matter if you saw them now or 5 years ago.
The original Chelsea Grin threw a much better show. I'll put it that way.
I think they were better, but they're still great now.
Yeah.
Their music's live is just phenomenal. But, I mean, the show they put on, like, yeah, the performance is good, but you don't even have to have a performance with it. Their music's just so good to see live, I think.
Yeah. I wouldn't say one's better than the other. That's awful. I hope you cut that part out.
Nope, that's going in there. So, yeah, let us know what you guys want to see next week. Maybe I'll do some beer chugs out of our buttholes. And
absolutely not.
Actually, we got to wait for the number one video. We got to wait till my competition goes over, which will be in 2 weeks when the number one video comes out, actually. So maybe I'm gonna chuck it out of my ass. Fuck your face. Fuck your cock. And fuck your pussy. Fuck her right in the pussy.